tonight, the three-year fight for women who experience baby loss. We speak to the mother behind Scotland's first dedicated unit for stillborn babies and miscarriage.
It's surreal knowing that as of next Thursday, women will no longer have to deliver in the labour ward. That's a massive achievement.
Also making the headlines, cancel culture hits the fringe. It's a showcase for queer talent, but artists fear their rights are under threat.
In sport, after a great night in Europe, Hearts and Hibs turn their attention to big Conference League playoff ties.
And pipers from around the globe descend on Glasgow for the annual World Championships.
I'm Emma Cameron in Edinburgh.
And I'm John Mackay in Glasgow. This is the STV News at 6. Good evening. Imagine knowing your baby had died in the womb and that you'd have to give birth on a labour ward surrounded by happy parents and healthy babies. That's what happened to Louise Caldwell in 2019 and led her to campaign for better facilities.
After 3 years, a petition and lobbying her local health board and the UK and Scottish governments, her hard work is paying off. Scotland's first baby loss delivery suite is due to open at a Lanarkshire hospital next week. And it's hoped more separate, soundproofed units will follow across the country. As Selina Jackson reports.
It's been a long 3 years for Louise Caldwell. After losing her baby back in 2019, she had to deliver on the labour wards, an experience which left her traumatised.
It's completely barbaric, it's so inhumane, and it's against women's rights to treat us like that.
Since then, she's been tirelessly campaigning for separate units. And now, NHS Lanarkshire says the first will open at University Hospital Wishaw in a matter of days.
I'm delighted, I'm absolutely over the moon, I'm overwhelmed that it's finally happened. It's surreal knowing that as of next Thursday, women will no longer have to deliver in the labour ward.
Louise created an online petition which has now gathered more than 34,000 signatures and went to Westminster to lobby politicians. The SNP included a pledge to deliver the suites in their 2021 election manifesto. Louise was told a pilot unit would open at Wishaw in October last year, but the project was plagued by delays.
I announced that it was going to be October 31st. That delay was fine. OK, these things happen. But then when it was delayed till December, and then I was told it was delayed, you know, till the summer holidays, it's difficult and it's so heartbreaking knowing that these women, especially women who's just had a loss, or their daughters had a loss, or their sisters had a loss, and they're asking are the units opening, that makes it so much more difficult for me.
I think lessons need to be learned here because communication is key, and it's clear that NHS Lanarkshire have a lot on their plate, but we do expect people to be treated with compassion and empathy and to be kept informed. But ultimately the buck stops with the Scottish Government. They made this promise to women and campaigners, they made this promise to families.
The Scottish Government says it's committed to providing dedicated facilities for women. Louise says while she's anxious that everything goes to plan this time, the process has been worth it.
Women are ecstatic. They've asked, like me, is it definitely opening? Will it open? What does it look like? Is it beside the labour ward? Is it staffed? So I've had all those questions. But for them that has daughters, for them that has a sister, they're ecstatic. They're absolutely over the moon that this campaign has changed so many women's lives when it comes to miscarriage or stillbirth.
Now Louise is determined to keep the momentum going and says she's already pushing for the next unit in Scotland so no other woman has to experience what she did. Selina Jackson, STV News.
Now, Father Ted writer Graham Linehan staged an impromptu performance of his cancelled fringe comedy show outside the Scottish Parliament last night after two Edinburgh venues refused to host the event due to concerns over the writer's gender-critical views.
Leith Archers was supposed to host the gig from Comedy Showcase but pulled out, saying his views did not align with their values. Well, our political reporter Laura Alderman is outside the Scottish Parliament for us tonight. And Laura, this has brought the issue of cancel culture to the fringe, hasn't it?
Yes, indeed, as you mentioned, after that second venue pulled out of hosting his stand-up show, Graham Linehan came here to the Scottish Parliament to perform, albeit it was a scaled-back performance with a smaller audience. But the writer said that the last few days had been some of the strangest of his career. Now, of course, The Fringe was founded by artists to uphold their values of access for all and inclusivity. And that's the exact reason why it's become such a magnet for queer performers and queer talent to flourish and find a community. But despite the steady rise in LGBTQI plus shows coming to The Fringe, performers have been telling me they still face barriers, discrimination and hostility when taking to the stage. Well, believe it or not, we're now more than halfway through this year's Fringe, so we've been taking a look at some of the best and brand new queer shows on offer and the impact they're making.
The People's Princess, as you've never seen her before. Diana, the untrue and untold story at the Pleasance Dome, is a joyful retelling of her life and time as a royal, earning 5-star reviews and sold-out performances.
With this show, I really wanted to create something that's very queer for a queer audience. People are happy to support queer art, and there's a hunger for queer art, which is wonderful.
The Bikini Pig.
Oops. I've seen a couple of comments online, or people saying that it's very, you know, distasteful or whatever, and then I do wonder if they say the same thing about The Crown. It's also worth remembering that for every protester there'll be 100 people who are here and are laughing and supporting and are just spreading the queer joy, and that is what I want to take away from it more than anything else.
I said, are you ready to read a story?
Every day in The Fringe, Ada HD brings stories to life for children in Drag Queen Story Hour, a show that's been consistently targeted by protesters.
Why would you take your children to see an adult entertainer?
The amount of people that I've spoken to, obviously, they are so shocked to hear that you have protesters against something such as, in some ways, as simple as a drag artist performing a storytelling show. Like, my goodness me, have they not heard of Pantomime or Mrs. Doubtfire? What I'm doing isn't controversial in any way whatsoever. I'm just being the person I wish that I had when I was 5 years old. The Fringe has probably been not only the loneliest, but the most fabulously liberating and exciting time I've ever had in my life.
Step into the deepest jungle, fly up to the highest height.
Liberation is a key theme of Brooke Tate's musical Birthmarked, which tells his own true story of being excluded as a Jehovah's Witness because of his sexuality.
As a queer performer, it's taken me a while for me to find confidence in myself, just in my everyday life as a queer person, because of what I went through and my upbringing. The reception that I've had from the queer community has been so encouraging, because it does take it takes a little bit of a step of courage to stand on stage and talk about queerness. There's so much joy to be had when you find your community.
I am a man and a shark ate my penis.
American-born Laser Webber's Fringe debut is all about figuring out who they are with the help of trans men throughout history.
When I was a kid, I didn't see trans people, and I think if I had seen them sooner, I wouldn't have lived a life of depression, suicidal ideation, loneliness the way I did. And so my goal in being visible at Edinburgh Fringe or anywhere is to show trans people are out here, we're living really happy lives, and it is okay to live your truth because it will make you happier. I have met so many incredible queer people, so many incredible kind people, and Edinburgh is beautiful.
Don't need a word.
Laura Alderman, STV News, Edinburgh.
No one else needs to get it but you.
With the number of Scots looking for work rising, the competition for available jobs is also increasing. Figures this week showed the unemployment rate rose, while there's been a sharp drop in the number of people in work.
The cost of living crisis is pushing more people to look for second jobs to pay bills. Our political correspondent Ewan Petrie has been speaking to people seeking work at a jobs fair.
And have you ever been interested in
paying? Around 1,200 people came to this fair, a sign of the difficulty in finding work.
A lot of people want people with experience, but are not employing people out of university who want to get that experience.
Scotland's unemployment rate rose to 4% between April and June, still below the UK rate. But the number out of work increased 24,000 on the first 3 months of the year.
How difficult are you finding things to get a new job?
It's hard work. I'm applying for everything and I can't get anything.
I know people are working 2-3 jobs, do you know what I mean? Just taking a survive in this world. I think it's ridiculous.
Higher inflation and interest rates have forced some companies to downsize. Rising costs are also creating barriers to getting work.
That could be, you know, the cost of energy, it could be just the cost of living and being able to get to and from interviews. So some of the support that we provide is through that barrier removal and supporting people in any need that they require.
Done a bad business deal as well, which left me penniless, and I've went into a real hard time for over a year.
One man who knows the value of events like this is Tony Fitzpatrick. The former St Mirren player, manager and chief executive found a new career at a jobs fair more than 20 years ago.
Changed my life. I'm being honest, I know it sounds dramatic. Changed my life completely. And it will. I look about me today, I see all age groups coming in. Doesn't matter if you're 16 or 67, 68 like me, you've got an opportunity.
With such stress on the labour market, it's an opportunity more and more people are hoping to take. Ewan Petrie, STV News.
Now, it's been a year since Scotland became the first country in the world to introduce free period products in public spaces. But how effective has the scheme been? Well, social work centres have told STV News the demand is high, especially amongst those in deprived areas.
Ivana Holland has been out testing the app that aims to help easier access to free products. Here's a report.
Packing up the essentials, the team at Hey Girls are working hard at their factory in Musselburgh, preparing the various products that will be sent out to the public and educational spaces to be made available for whoever needs them. It's a way to help with period poverty and overcome barriers to what was once a taboo subject.
It's just been a fantastic thing to be a part of. We don't want anyone to have to go and ask for a product, because that is the period dignity side of it and the period poverty side of it. People still feel the stigma of picking up free products. So each council does the same. They come to us and we work out a plan. So some bulk buy and others we actually deliver products directly to the door of the people who need them.
The legislation was introduced last August and the Scottish Government says it's allocated £6.1 million to local authorities for the coming year. It said in a statement that it's more important than ever to provide the scheme when people are making difficult choices due to the cost of living crisis.
Well, I've got my Pick Up My Period app, which you can download for free, and just simply tap on the map and it shows you all the places where you can find some free period products if you're caught short. So I'm here outside Fountain Bridge Library. I go and check and see if it's as well stocked as it says it is on the app. So just been inside Fountain Bridge Library, and whilst the products are out in a public space and amongst the books, it's definitely well stocked, so definitely applicable according to the app. So let's go and check out a few more places around town.
We went to spots around Edinburgh, including sports centres, fringe venues and social work sites. Only one place had no stock in, and that was a healthy living centre. Others say the demand has been high, especially during the festival, but particularly in deprived areas where the products are replaced daily. The picture is equally different for schoolgirls, whose experiences range from trolleys loaded with products to others saying the items are locked in the medical room. After 12 months, the scheme has been shown to be popular, but not necessarily universal. Ivana Holland, STV News, Edinburgh.
The former Celtic and Scotland striker Lee Griffiths has admitted endangering the lives of football fans by booting a lit flare into a crowd of supporters. The incident happened during a match in September 2021. The 32-year-old could face up to 12 months in jail. Sentencing was deferred. Glasgow is the second most expensive place in the UK for students to live. Figures from the Royal Bank of Scotland suggest only Edinburgh ranks worse when student income is compared to living costs in the area. Average rent for students has increased by 30% since last year.
It's just an incredibly stressful time. If you're coming to Glasgow or Edinburgh or anywhere else in Scotland to study, finding somewhere to live that you know you're going to be able to afford for the whole year is just proven to be almost an impossible task. And that's not the way we want people to be starting their college or university experience.
Private landlords could help end homelessness. A report by the Everyone Home Collective, made up of 40 charities and academics, says the private rented sector could be a viable option for homeless people. The group is calling for support from councils and the Scottish and UK governments.
The Scottish Government exploring its own social security powers to top up local housing allowance so that the private rented sector is more accessible to people experiencing homelessness. And similarly, the UK Government really must reconsider its decision to freeze housing benefit, because that's really one of the main factors that's locking people at the moment out of the private rented sector.
Inverclyde has become the first part of Scotland to provide free school meals for all primary pupils. They are already available to children in primary 1 to 5 across the country, but now the local authority is extending that to older children. Here's our senior reporter, Gordon Cree.
The first lunchtime of the new school year at Ardgowan Primary in Greenock. Hundreds of children have their lunch here, and it's now free for all of them.
Yeah, it's as good as it always was. Yeah, very nice.
I just like that they're really yummy.
They work hard to do it every single day and they taste really good.
The head teacher says the new approach is timely.
With the impact of cost of living, the increase in poverty, absolutely the free school entitlement for every child is going to make a huge difference to parents and to our pupils. It also means that they have the opportunity to get a hot meal every single day, which I think is vital and so important for the children's development.
The Scottish Government had planned to expand free meals to primary 6 and 7s last year, but it's not now expected to happen until 2024. So the council in Inverclyde is spending £350,000 to fund it themselves.
As we know, there is always that stigma attached to free school meals. By having that universal benefit throughout primary school, it cuts away with that totally.
Four choices are available each day, including healthy options to help with a balanced diet.
There's menus sent out to the parents probably days before the kids come back. The school does that, sends it out, and the parents can then go through all the menus with the kids and they can decide the night before. The parents can say, well, this is on tomorrow, what would you like? And then when they come in the next day, they're not panicking, thinking, I don't know what's going to be on.
The council says kitchens at schools across the region will be upgraded during this school year with the anticipation of extra demand. Gordon Cree, STV News.
You can see him. He's standing by. It's Raman.
Thanks very much, Sean. Good evening to you all. It was a great night in Europe for the Edinburgh clubs after Hibernian knocked out Luzern. Jordan Obita says they can't wait to host Aston Villa in the playoff round of the Europa Conference League. Meanwhile, Cammy Devlin says the Hearts fans helped them come from behind to defeat Rosenborg 3-1, a result which sets up a playoff tie against Pauk in the same competition. Jamie Borthwick reports.
As the final whistle blew on a momentous result for Hibernian in Switzerland, 900 miles away back home in Edinburgh.
Can he find the winner? He can! Oh, it's Cam Devlin!
A memorable night for the capital clubs was sealed at Tynecastle.
Whether it took 90, 120 penalties, it was about sticking in there, and I'm sure I know that all the boys did that. And yeah, the crowd were unbelievable, and it's about us giving back. They pay a lot of money to come watch us play week in, week out, and it's for reasons like that, for nights like that, and yeah, that's just us giving back to them, and they're a massive reason as to why we're through.
Hearts, who today confirmed the season-long loan arrival of Odell Fire from Brighton, suffered an early setback against Rosenborg, but dug deep to score three unanswered goals and progress to the playoff round.
Character. Just sums up the team. You know, he come back, you know, 3-1 down and aggregate 1-0 on the night and score three goals to take us through is immense credit to them.
Hibs made the best possible start when Eli Yuan netted to extend the aggregate lead over Luzern to 4-1. The Swiss got within a goal of levelling before Yuan rounded off a memorable individual performance by setting up Martin Boyle to seal the tie.
He's a game changer. He's a game winner. So him and Boyle tonight were excellent, worked hard off the ball, and then they got the quality to get the goals in the game as well.
And the prize for Hibs, a showdown with John McGinn's Aston Villa.
At Villa Park is a very good atmosphere, and obviously they're incredible players, you know. They sign players for, you know, 20, 30 million, so it's always going to be a tough game, home or away, but it's always nice to have it at home first.
The results mean that all five Scottish teams are still involved in Europe at the playoff stage for the first ever time. Villa head to Easter Road on Wednesday, while Hearts will take on PAOK of Greece on Thursday night. Jamie Borthwick, STV News.
Cameron Carter-Vickers and Rio Hatate will miss Celtic's League Cup clash against Kilmarnock on Sunday due to injury. Brendan Rodgers says the pair's fitness will be monitored in the coming weeks. Stephen Welsh, who signed a new contract, has suffered a knock. Meanwhile, as Rangers prepare to face Morton in the Cup, Ravi Matondo hopes this could be a good opportunity to impress Michael Beale. Here's Ronnie Chatters.
Both of their games were cut short against Aberdeen at the weekend, and they won't be seen in a Celtic jersey in the near future. Rio Hatate with a calf injury and Cameron Carter-Vickers a hamstring problem, meaning Gustav Lagerbielka could make his Celtic debut in defence against Kilmarnock. And with the derby against Rangers just 2 weeks away, just how quickly will the pair return?
Yeah, just obviously not available for this weekend, so we just have to assess them and see how they are over the coming weeks. A highly rated young player, and we look forward to seeing him play. The club here have got a great pipeline of players that are in place, and there's always a plan if one is to move on. So he's one that's been the guys have looked at for a long time.
Meanwhile at Ibrox, after a lack of game time for Rangers, Rabi Matondo is eyeing the League Cup game against Morton as a chance to show what he's all about. The winger impressed after coming on as a substitute in the 4-0 win over Livingston last weekend.
Of course, the manager's brought a lot of talent in, and that's what happens at clubs like Rangers. Like, we got a lot of talent, we got a lot of, you know, competition, but that's what you want, and that's what you have at big clubs. So for me, it's just about knowing what I can bring to the team and showing what I can, you know, do when given the opportunity.
Ronnie Charters, STV News.
St Mirren manager Stephen Robinson hopes an extended run in the League Cup could give the club the financial boost to do more transfer business. The Saints face Motherwell in the last 16 tomorrow. They go into the match after defeating Dundee in the Premiership.
The further you progress, the more I can cajole people and speak to people nicely and see what we can get. But we know what positions squad-wise we're light in. A few more numbers would be great, but a cup run helps. You know, as I said, it eases the pressure on finances and allows people to support even more than what they do.
Well, the last 16 League Cup fixtures get underway tonight. Stirling Albion host Aberdeen. The other ties are spread over Saturday and Sunday. Airdrieonians are at home to Ross County, while Livingston welcome Ayr United. After their wins in Europe, Hearts face Partick Thistle and Hibs take on Raith Rovers. They are both 2 o'clock kickoffs. And some golf news before I go. Conor Syme is a top Scot on day two of the latest DP World Tour event in Northern Ireland. He's on 3 under par. 8 shots off the lead. That's all sport tonight.
Thanks for that, Raman. Well, now Philip is here with that weekend weather forecast.
Get set for a wet spell. TUI sponsors STV Weather.
Hello and a very good evening to you. Well, this morning Met Erin, which is the Irish National Meteorological Service, named an area of low pressure approaching as Storm Betty. And that will bring with it strong winds and heavy rainfall overnight tonight and into tomorrow. So unfortunately, it will be a bit of an unsettled start to the weekend. As we head through this evening and overnight, we're continuing to see the winds pick up strength, seeing gusts of around 40 to 50 miles per hour, particularly around the coasts and on higher ground. And through the early hours of tomorrow morning, we'll see the arrival of this large band of heavy rainfall moving northwards. Temperature-wise, with all the wind, the rain and the cloud not dropping too far, lows of around 14 or 15 degrees Celsius. Looking ahead to tomorrow, a windy start to the day. We'll continue to see those areas of rain pushing northwards. They will be heaviest through the course of the morning, but even in the afternoon, we'll still see some frequent heavy showers. But despite that, it will be feeling warm and muggy out and about because we're in a southerly airflow, dragging in that warmer air. Highs tomorrow of around 20 or 21 degrees Celsius. Now, looking ahead to Sunday, and it will be a better day overall. Storm Betty has now cleared to the north and the northwest. Still some strong winds across across the northwest highlands. Away from that, though, we will see some brighter, sunnier intervals. One or two showers, but those are blowing through quickly thanks to the strength of the winds. Bye-bye.
TUI sponsors STV Weather.
Great. Now, the 75th World Pipe Band Championships are underway with thousands from across the world taking part in the competition.
Yes, the event at Glasgow Green will run for 2 days with around 40,000 spectators expected tomorrow. It's considered to be the most important event in the calendar for performers all vying to be crowned world champion. As Susan Ripple reports.
You can see it in their faces. This is the event of the year for these musicians.
I have been with other bands who've won it, but I wasn't there either, so I've never won it.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. So, I mean, how hopeful are you then for you guys this year that maybe this will be the year that you'll be able to win?
Yeah, you always have that hope, don't you? But I don't know. You never know. Anything could happen.
This band from Canada have been world champions 6 times before.
We worked toward this all year, and there's a lot of preparation that go into this with regard to our competition performances, but also our other concert performances that help round out the band.
The members of Manawatu Scottish Pipe Band have travelled from New Zealand to be here.
The last time we were here was 2018, and we were supposed to come in 2020, but obviously COVID hit and the world locked down. And it's really special to be back. It's good to be back. We've built a new band basically over COVID. A lot of young guys, a lot of people that haven't played at the Worlds before, so this was their first time playing with us today, so it's really special.
These band members from Los Angeles are competing at their first World Championships.
It's the whole culture here. It's like we feel like we finally like know like what this is and what it means to this people, so it's really exciting to be out here and like see everyone in this community. Especially yeah. Since back in California, no one knows what a pipe band is or like anything about pipe bands. So coming here and seeing everyone understand it and knowing what it means is like completely different.
And for those who just want to enjoy the music, there'll be even more to see and hear tomorrow. Susan Ripple, STV News, Glasgow.
Someday. And finally, we all have a good idea what we think Bonnie Prince Charlie looked like. Now we know for real.
Yes, the face of Bonnie Prince Charlie has been recreated by academics from Dundee University, who used death masks and technology to produce this lifelike replica of him. It's hoped the work will encourage people to see him as a person and not just a legend. I think that was in the days before spray tans. What do you think, John?
Well, you do a face scrub as well, but that's a bit unfair. Different times. Thank you for watching. Have a good weekend.
Bye-bye for now.